Hey guys, it's Arena. Welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys have been well. Cannot believe it's already December and the end of 2018. November was yet another crazy, hectic month. Some highlights I wanted to share with you guys was one, it was my husband's birthday and my son had his Christmas concert at school. He had his first somewhat long speaking part and he was so nervous about it. I think 2 days before the actual concert, he started talking about how he was so scared and nervous to be in front of so many people and have to say his lines. He wasn't sure if he was gonna remember them. And a funny thing that he said to me was like, "Mom, I think I might want to cancel it." And I was like, "Sweetheart, you can't cancel it. We're gonna have to go through with it." And I tried my best to really cheer him on, but he did really well, despite the fact that he was a bit nervous, and we were so proud of him. Besides that, the dust levels in Korea were horrible throughout the month. That made it hard for us because usually after school, we love going to the playground or going for walks, but we ended up having to always come home and I had to figure out activities to do at home. So that was a bit difficult, but we did make do and hopefully the air will clear up by the time Christmas comes around, hopefully. Really excited about the three things that I've been loving this month. There's a lot of new products that I try regularly, but the ones that I really mention on my monthly favorites are the ones that I absolutely love and feel they add great value or convenience to my life, and I hope that you enjoy them too. One product that I've been absolutely loving this month is a makeup product. Now, one of my must-have items that I repurchase on a yearly basis is a mineral finishing powder by Laura Mercier. Now, what I love about this powder is that it doesn't look cakey, it looks very natural, and it still somewhat maintains that glowiness of the skin from the foundation. So it doesn't make your skin look really matte. So I use this to set my entire face. Now, sadly, I've been noticing that I've been getting fine lines under my eyes, which are my laugh lines, but these wrinkles are very fine. So I find that by the end of the day, a lot of my makeup ends up building up in the small creases, which doesn't look nice. So I looked into some powders and I found that Laura Mercier also has a powder made for under the eyes. Now this product is called the Secret Brightening Powder for Under Eyes and it's in shade number 1, but it looks completely translucent to me. It's very finely milled, so it goes right, it fills in those really fine lines. It's really, really nice. By the end of the day, there's no weird buildups. You can't see the creases. It really blurs all the fine lines on your face, which is really, really nice. I can definitely see this one also becoming a staple in my makeup routine because it just looks so natural. Now, the way I like to use it is I would usually kind of give it a quick shake, and the residue that is left on the lid is the amount that I would use. It's actually not that much. I use it with my Picasso brush in number 104. It's an angled brush, usually used for highlighting your face, but this works really well. So I kind of just mix it in and get it in, give it a few taps, and then lightly put it under my eyes. And that sets my makeup all day long. Looks super natural, and again, still glowy, and no creases by the end of the day. The next thing I've been loving and finally have gotten to finishing it is this book called The Opposite of Spoiled. This was a book that was gifted to me by my dear friend Yeri. It's by Ron Lieber and it's a book that teaches parents how to raise children who are financially responsible, who are grounded, who are respectful, kind, generous. And it's a revolutionary book that I think every parent needs to read because we live in a society where it's very uncomfortable and even taboo, even among adults, to talk about money or how much a person earns or how much certain things cost. And So it's so important to have that open and honest dialogue with your children, and that's exactly what this book recommends you to do at a very young age. So the younger you expose your children to the idea of money and the idea of managing and budgeting your finances is just so important, because the more experience they have, the better they'll be, the wiser they'll be when they get older. One of my biggest fears is to spoil my kids. They live very comfortable lives. We live in a modern city. It's the first world where everything is in abundance. Everybody wants more. Everybody has too many things. So this book really puts into perspective and teaches you how to teach your kids when enough is enough, when you have enough things, and it also teaches them about spending wisely and making smart decisions about their money. Now, the book starts off first by defining the meaning of spoiled. Lieber says there are several ways. The first is sort of the obvious one, which is having too many materialistic things. Other ways you can spoil your children are just the lack of responsibilities, not having enough set rules and schedules in place, and also even spending too much time or paying too much attention to your children to a point where they are so dependent on you for certain choices and decisions. It gives a lot of practical tips and advice on how you can help your children understand money at a very young age. So my kids are fairly young. So for me, the most important sort of points were giving your children allowance that is reasonable for their age regularly, so that they can learn to save and be patient and spend on something that they truly love and need. So for older kids, it's really important for them to have a job, because through having that job, that will allow them to learn about budgeting and managing their finances. And that teaches them responsibility with their money, but it also teaches them other important skills like communication skills and reliability. They have to be on time for work, things like that. I highly recommend this book to every parent, even if you're not a parent. I think it's a really good read. So the last and final favorite thing this month is an app called Blinkist. What it is it's an app that is a library of thousands of nonfiction books that have been condensed to 15-minute summaries. So they basically take like the essence of the book and just tell you the most important points. So yeah, the reason why I was a little bit iffy about trying it was just, it just didn't feel right to read a book or listen to a book that wasn't the exact words of the author. It just didn't feel right. Kind of felt like when I was young, you know, when you learn like Shakespeare or something, and then they have like a For Dummies book that basically summarizes everything, and you kind of feel guilty reading it. That's exactly what how I felt like in the beginning. But I tried it for 7 days because they give you a free trial, and I fell in love with it. Reason being, I love audiobooks, so as you guys probably know, I love Audible. But for me, because I love to read and I love to consume new information, especially through nonfiction books, I just find that my list of books to read are just—it's just getting longer and longer, and I just don't have the time. So for the list of books that I do want to read, I think it's sort of divided into two parts. The first group is a list of books that I absolutely am like wanting to read, like from the first page to the last. So something like that I would listen to on Audible. And then there are books that sort of pique my interest and I kind of want to read, but I don't have the time for it, so I will just listen to it through Blinkist. So after doing that, if I feel like, oh, I want to kind of dive deeper into that book, then I will listen to it on Audible. So this has worked really, really well. I find that the app is very useful, and it's great for somebody who is very busy, but also is very interested in improving all different aspects of their life. And another way I use this app is for like some of my favorite books, including this one, The Opposite of Spoiled. As much as you love a book, sometimes your memory just fades. So you kind of need that refresher. So Blinkist is really good in that way. They do have a fee of, I think, 79,000 won here in Korea. It's a yearly fee, but I definitely think it's well worth the money. So those are my favorites for this month. Finally, it's December, soon to be Christmas. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget that I always leave links to any of the products I've mentioned down in the description box. If you have any questions, feel free to leave comments down below. Thank you so much for watching as always, and I will see you guys next time. Bye for now. 안녕!